Welcome to the video tutorial on how to create Windows to go with Ventoy. You should not use USB drives because the experience is very bad. Therefore, I recommend that you use a solid-state drive to create Windows to go. To create Windows to go, I used an enclosure to connect to the computer using a USB port. I'm going to make it a Windows to go. You follow these steps. I have four folders as above and I will perform the following steps one by one. I put the software download link in the description. Partition style GPT. First, I installed Ventoy on the target solid state drive. You format the partition named Ventoy as NTFS. This is the partition after completing the Ventoy installation. Next, download the Windows ISO file from the Microsoft home page. Then you create a Windows virtual machine using VirtualBox software. On VirtualBox, create a new Windows 11 virtual machine. You name and save the virtual machine to the folder you have prepared. Choose the operating system version you will use. In this case, I choose Windows 11 Pro. Set up username for Windows. You can customize the hardware if you want. I left it as default. Next, choose the hard drive format for the Windows virtual machine as VHD. Because Ventoy boots Windows to go with VHD format. Be sure to choose the correct hard drive format. After completing the creation of a new virtual machine, install the Windows operating system for it. I'll quickly rewind the steps to install Windows because it's quite familiar to us. After completing the Windows installation, turn off the virtual machine. You navigate to the file storage folder with the extension VHD of the newly created virtual machine. You copy this file and paste it to the solid-state drive used as Windows to go. A folder named Ventoy was created in the previous step. To boot the Windows.vhd file, you need one more file. This file is responsible for booting the file with the extension VHD. In the folder named Ventoy, create a new folder named Ventoy. Copy and paste the vhdboot.img file into the folder named Ventoy that was just created. In the Ventoy folder, there are two important files. One is the Windows.vhd file and the vhdboot.img file. You need both of these files to create a Windows to go kit. Now let's check the results by starting the newly created Windows to go suite. You access the UEFI BIOS and set up your computer to boot from the Windows to go kit. This is the interface of Ventoy software. You select the Windows.vhd file and start Windows. Started Windows to go successfully. I have completed the steps to create a Windows to go kit with Ventoy. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck.